Hello everyone, welcome to Programming Cradle. It's been a while, I haven't made a video. I was quite busy with my assignments. So now that I have submitted my both the assignments for data visualization as well as statistics, I have some time until next assignment kicks in. So yeah, so here's the video. And in this video, I wanted to discuss about some of the tips that I would like to give you if you are coming to the UK or if you're going to some other place where assessments are mostly based on your coursework or your projects or some practical assignments that you get. So it will definitely help you, because back in India during my bachelor's, I just had to study a night before and I was able to clear exams. So it was pretty easy, right? But then here things are very different. You have to do projects, you have to make report, and then you have to write your code, and in that you have to explain what your code is doing with your comments and all those things. So it takes time. It's not like you can just do it in an hour or something like that. Of course, if you can do, that's pretty phenomenal, but then at least for me it's not possible. So it takes time. You should give at least a week to complete the project properly. You can do that in like 2-3 days coding part, but then other things, it takes time. You need to, like I told you, you need to format your code properly, then you have to add comments, and then you need to explain your code, and also report is also there. So you need to do all those things. So yeah, that's the thing you need to keep in mind. Don't leave it until the end, and make your submissions on time, because at least in my university, it's like if you submit after the deadline, you will have some penalties. So why you want to lose marks by submitting late? So as soon as you get your problem statement or project, try to read it, and if you don't know the concepts, watch video lectures if you have, or simply ask your faculty or the teacher, whoever is taking that particular subject. And you might be having notes on your university's portal, you can refer those notes. So yeah, as soon as you get your assignments or projects, go through the questions even though you don't know the concept. With that, you will know that what things you need to focus on, and you will know the keywords. So when you are watching your lectures, or if you are watching, or if you are reading notes, you will be able to pick like, yes, I read this thing in question, so this might be important. Or if you are not able to understand the keywords in the question, simply Google them. And with that, you will at least have a basic foundation about that particular keyword or the concept. So when you are watching the videos or reading notes, it will clear your concepts even more. So yeah, that's something I would like to tell you, and don't leave it until end. So in my case, I had data visualization and statistics. So data visualization, it was not like there wasn't any right or wrong answer. In that, all you had to do was present your data. You had to make a dashboard, and you had to show it to the commander, and he wanted to make decision which area to give first aid. It was basically infection, airborne infection in Manchester. So you had to make a dashboard to help the commander to make decision. So yeah, this was the gist of the question. And then we had to plot different data and use different plotting tools, and basically we did everything in Power BI. So we had to present our dashboard, and we had to keep in mind about the colors we are using. It should be fine for colorblind people, and it should be printable. So yeah, we had to keep all those things in mind. And data was pretty easy, so even if you do some minor calculation mistake, you will still get the right answer. I mean, the region which is actually infected. So in that regard, it was pretty easy. But then the colors which you need to choose, and the right plot that you should use, and how to present it to the commander so that he doesn't have to think a lot, and assuming that he is not from stats background. So all those things we had to keep in mind, and it was quite confusing, because when we do data exploratory data analysis for our own projects, we know the statistical terms, and even if we simply plot a histogram or maybe a line chart or maybe scatter plot, we are able to understand our data and we can proceed. But then if we are showing those plots to a layman, he or she might not be able to understand, right? So we need to use proper tools which is easy to understand. So that is what we had to keep in mind, and it took quite a lot of time. I thought I just read the problem statement and I was like, okay, it's pretty straightforward and it won't take much time. But then when I actually started working on it, it took quite a lot of time. So don't underestimate any assignment, even if you are able to understand the question properly. Try to do it as soon as possible and submit it way before your deadline. And for statistics, we had two assignments. One was for Poisson distribution and then likelihood. There were two different questions. So we had to write code and we had to see if a particular process or the data which is generated, is it following Poisson distribution, and then we had to use maximum likelihood to find the best theta value. So we had to do all those things in R. Again, I am very new to R, so it was not a problem because I wrote a pseudocode and then I simply googled for loop in R, if statement in R, how to find log likelihood in R and all those things. So it wasn't a big deal. But then if I had known R before, it would have been much easier. Or if I was doing this in Python, I could have done it much faster. So that's why it took time. But then the good thing is I learned R. So always look on the positive side. I'm still not sure that I'll be using R for a long time, because if I will have freedom to choose a programming language, I will obviously choose Python. But then knowing another language is a plus thing, or maybe knowing extra concepts, definitely it helps. So that's a good thing. And for the second assignment in stats, it was a project we had to do again data exploratory analysis and over a data set. It was Palmer Archipelago Penguin data set. So we had to do data analysis on that data, and we had to do some hypothesis testing. There were some questions we had to answer using hypothesis testing. So that is the thing, and it was also good. I personally won't say that I was satisfied with the project that I did, but then because I think I could have done better. But it is what it is now, and now that I know that even though you are able to understand the questions, it's not like when you are actually implementing it, it's not like you will be able to do it in an hour or something like that. You will have to give a significant amount of time to your assignments, and it's not just about coding. It is actually following the best practices, and then you have to make reports and stuff. So you need to keep those things in mind as well. So yeah, this is what I wanted to discuss in this video. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you want these kind of videos in future, feel free to subscribe to the channel. It's completely free, and also it keeps me motivated to make such videos for you guys. And if you want to download data science notes, the link is in the description. You can download that, and you can also join our Telegram group. There we have over 1,000 people who are helping each other on a daily basis. And yeah, so this is it for this video, and please don't forget to subscribe to the channel. It keeps me motivated to make such videos for you guys. So see you in the next video. Bye. Happy learning.